In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at how we can edit the control center on the iPhone with iOS 18. Apple completely changed how this all works, and they added more features. As an example, when we look at my iPhone here and we go to the control center, you're going to see that I have larger controls. In addition to that, I can also swipe up to get to more controls. It's almost like I have different home screens for different controls. That's what we're going to be taking a look at in this video, how we can edit this control center. Now, before we get started, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll have a little bit more about me and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at how we can edit the control center on the iPhone with iOS 18. Let's go over to my iPhone. Now, if you're familiar with editing the control center prior to iOS 18, what we did is we went to the Settings app, and there's an actual setting in here for control center. And when we tap on this, what we're able to do is add controls to our control center. Well, if we look here, you're going to see that is completely blank. This is where we go and add those controls. The only option we have here is if we want the control center to be accessible when we're in any app, or if we just want it when we're on the home screen. If I turn this off, the only way I can get to the control center is when I'm on the home screen. If I'm in an app, I can no longer access that control center. So that's the only setting that we have on here. So how do we edit the control center? Well, basically what we need to do is we need to go to the control center itself. So I have an iPhone 14, and what I need to do to get to the control center is just swipe down from the upper right-hand corner. And when I do, I get to my control center. So we have to access our control center. Now from here, what we need to do is we need to go into the edit mode. When we're in the edit mode, we can remove controls, move them, and even add controls. So how do we get into that edit mode? Well, we have two different ways. I can tap on the plus here in the upper left-hand corner, and it takes me into the edit mode. Or what I can do is I can just long press in this area here where there is no control. And when I do, it takes me over to the edit mode. So now I'm in the edit mode. What I'm able to do is move these controls around. I can rearrange them. So if I wanted low power mode here to be in the upper left-hand corner, I want to move it up here. All I have to do is just drag this and place it up there. In the past, we weren't able to change the top of the control center. Now we have complete customization with this control center. In addition to that, you're going to see that beside each control in the lower right-hand corner, there's a little bold arc there. You can see it there, we can see it here, and we can see it here. It's not on all controls, it is not on these here, so you're not going to see it on every control, but if you see that little arc there, that means that you can resize that control. So now, all I need to do is just drag that, so let's just go ahead and drag that, and you're going to see I can make that low power mode smaller and larger. All I have to do is just drag that. And again, if I want to move it, I just drag it and place it where I want. If you want to remove a control, you just tap on the minus here, and it'll remove that control. And you're going to notice that we can remove every control in here. So if you wanted to remove everything, you could start with a blank slate and then just go and add your own controls. So how do we add controls? Well, to add controls, we just go down to the bottom here. When I tap on it, it's going to show me all of the different controls that I have available to me. Depending on your iPhone and what third-party apps, you may see more or less of these controls. When I swipe up, you're going to see that I have quite a few controls here. Now, in addition to just scrolling to look for it, we can also search for a control. I have a video on how we can add background sounds. There's a background sound control. Well, instead of looking for it by scrolling, what I can do is tap on search, and I type in here background, and you're going to see I found that control. So that's how we can find the control. So once we find the control, what do we do? Well, basically, all we have to do is tap on the control we want to add, and it'll add it to our control center. So let's say that I wanted to add screen recording. I just go and tap on it, and we can see it added screen recording. Now, right now it's a little bit small, so let's just go ahead and make it a little bit larger. Maybe I use that quite a bit. So I just drag that little corner there, and I can make it larger. When I am done, I just tap in this area here, and it's going to save those changes. So those are the basics of editing the control center, but we do have more. When I go back into the edit mode, so I'm going to long press in this area here. It goes into the edit mode. Again, I can remove them just by tapping on the minus. I can drag them around. To move them around, I can resize them. But in addition to that, we also have more control screens, kind of like more home screens. I'm going to call them control screens. So you're going to see over here on the right, we have little indicators there, little icons indicating the different control screens. So now when I swipe up, you're going to see there's a little music note here. When I swipe up, what it's going to do is it's going to show me my music, what music I'm playing. I swipe up again, and now I have these different controls here. And then if I swipe up again, you're going to see I have a little circle here. When I swipe up, that gives me the blank slate. So I can go and add controls to this little area here. And once I add those, when I go back into the standard mode, I just tap to get out of the edit mode. I still have these different areas here. All I have to do is just swipe to go to my different controls. So you could group your different controls together and put them on different screens if you wanted to. So that is how we edit the control center on the iPhone with iOS 18. As you can see, it's really not too bad. When I first saw this, I thought it was going to be a little bit overwhelming, but when we go to our control center here and we want to edit it, we just tap and hold. If I want to move a control around, I just drag it where I want. Pretty simple. I want to resize one. I just take the arc in the lower right-hand corner and I can drag it to resize any one of them. I can also remove any one of them just by tapping on the minus here. And then if I want to go and add a new screen, I can just swipe up and add a new screen and add my own controls here. To delete a screen, we just go and delete all of the controls on that screen. So if I tapped on this minus here, it would delete that screen. Just remove all the controls and it'll remove that screen. So that is how we edit the control center on the iPhone with iOS 18. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can also subscribe to my channel, and you can click on the bell to receive notifications when I release a new video. But even more than that, what you can do is you can check out my site, danstutorials.com. Not dance tutorials, but Dan's tutorials. On YouTube, I have over 400 videos, but on my site, I have over 2,100 videos. I've been working on my site a lot longer than I have with YouTube. In addition to that, to help support my efforts, the site is a membership-based site. You don't have to become a member, but when you do become a member, all of the videos are ad-free, so I take out all of the ads on all of the videos. Also, you get access to my live classes and my Ask Me Anythings. I hold those on a regular basis. And probably most important is you're helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office in my house creating these videos. So in addition to everything else, you are helping support a small business. So if you like what you see, check out danstutorials.com. So that is how we edit the control center on the iPhone with iOS 18.